Thanks for clicking on the video, guys. It's going to be an absolutely epic one this time. But also, you're going to want to keep watching because there's going to be a competition hidden somewhere in this video. Welcome to the latest video, guys, and what a treat we've got in store for you today. It's the Christmas special on the Preston Innovations YouTube channel, and we've got an epic match in store for you today. We've got Des Shipp versus Lee Kerry at Medlands Fishery in a silverfish battle. Now, these two anglers, I don't need to big them up. They're two of the very best anglers in the world. The form, their achievements, simply incredible. Now, the format today, silverfish only, 3 hours, pole only silverfish match. It's going to be an amazing battle. These two, I know it's only light-hearted, it's a bit of fun, but they'll be desperate to beat each other, and I can't wait to find out how it goes down. So let's get on the pegs, get the pegs drawn, and see how they're going to approach the match.
Right, big moment. This is the draw. What's the flyer, Des? What's the flyer?
I honestly don't care, to be honest.
Really?
Well, we've got so much space. It's like, and I don't draw MPEG, so I'm quite happy because I'm actually going to be on.
I'm saying you'll actually be on an MPEG today.
We have got a guy to our left, so.
What, 20 pegs away?
The peg I would fancy is 17 because I got more room in the
Go on then, you pick 17 now. Go on, off you go. Go
Zolt,
on.
You do the draw.
No, go on, you
no,
do it.
Don't no. you do the draw.
Don't put it in Zolt's hands.
And we kits so on.
17.
Oh, you haven't drawn the one you wanted.
So, yeah, I knew it was going to happen. It's obvious, isn't it? It's obvious. Well, it's pretty obvious he's going to be on 17.
Hey, on, it's 19.
It's obvious, isn't it? That's why I put me. That's why I've got me ground bait already on my platform
because I knew I was going to draw. Both pegs are the same.
I knew I was going to draw pants. That's the normal result. Thank you very much for that. I told you to pull it out your sleeve, did I? And drop it in after.
All right. Let's go get some gear. Come on, let's go get some gear.
So let's get going.
Everyone reckons this is the absolute flyer. What do you reckon?
Well, I mean, I've spoke to a few people. Obviously, there's been a match on here over the weekend. There was lots of silverfish, which is what this video is obviously about, this film, the head-to-head with Lee. And I was told that really you want to be nearer the trees, which are down to Lee's right. So I can only go from that. The match was actually won. I will point this out. The match was won 2 pegs to Lee's right. 1 or 2 days ago, so that's all I'm going to say. I'm not going to say anything else.
And you have got an angler to your left.
I have got an angler to my left as well, so it's normal stuff for me. End pegs don't happen for me. Obviously, Lee's on the biggest end peg possible. He's probably got at least 3/4 of a mile to his left, or to his right, rather. But at the end of the day, it's what it is. It looks lovely. They've been catching some real big roach. Odd skimmers. I think the skimmers have been probably being caught on the feeder rather than the pole, and this whole thing today is pole fishing. And I've obviously mixed ground bit up accordingly to what I found out. So yeah, at the end of the day, Lee's a great angler and it's going to be a tough one because I think with the conditions, it's really, really cold. The wind chill must be like zero. It's cold, isn't it? So it might take us a while to actually get the fish feeding. I think we're going to catch some fish. I've seen some roach top already, which is always a good sign, isn't it? So hopefully, yeah, it's typical Lee Kerry, end peg, or he has a real nice sort of 20 meter chuck on the Feeder Masters final. So whatever way, I can't win, can I really? But there you go, we'll give it our best shot.
Sorry, what do you think? Peg 17?
Well, it's the one that everyone wanted to draw, I think. I don't know, look, we've never been here before. It looks fantastic. I've done a couple of features here, no fish to match here. I think Des is the same, might have fished once or twice. We've told there's loads of fish. I'm really looking forward to it. It's cold. It's a classic winter silverfish day. You know, this is the sort of day that you you sort of look for. It's not frozen, but it's going to be a little bit slow to start with, is my guess. And then there's going to be a few bites. So I'm really looking forward to it. I think it looks fantastic. I've heard it's quite deep. I'm quite excited, you know, to fish here rather than, usually if I'm doing a feature or something, you don't get to fish properly. So I'm really excited to have sort of 3 hours serious fishing. So hopefully it'll be all right. And obviously the mission is to wind up Des as much as possible, which is generally not too hard. So we'll have a bit of fun with that along the way. Really looking forward to it. Okay, so the plan is today to try and feed two lines. Now, I think often when I'm fishing for silverfish, I think two lines are important. And I believe that, like, on your longer line, you're trying to look for more quality fish. And that's usually skimmers or bream or something like that. So I don't tend to go too nuts on my long line. I tend to use, like, less bait because I don't really want to draw in any, like, little fish. And then closer in, I want to be more aggressive. I want to feed more bait. I want to try and draw the active fish towards me. They're quicker to catch and I can catch them, you know, without shipping all the way out. I can use lighter rigs. There's lots of benefits to that. That's because today on that short line, it actually plumbs up a lot shallower than the longer line. It's about 9, maybe 9.5 foot on my short line, and it's probably 11, 11.5 foot, something like that, on my longer line. Now, again, I don't want to be doing is shipping all the way out to a full 13 meters, dropping a rig in, going all the way through that depth just to ship a small roach back. So I'm going to encourage them to come closer. So that means on my close line, I'm going to feed a lot more of my ground bait mix. Now, my mix is dead simple. It's three parts F1 Dark, one part Thatcher's, but I've actually put a handful of Leam in there as well. It's very deep. I need a bit of weight, added weight into my mix. So that's what I've done. So I always like to measure out what I'm going to do. This is 3/4 of a litre. So I'm going to actually put 3 litres on my short line. Now that might seem like a lot of ground bait to some people, okay? But the idea is I want to create a nice big carpet on that short line. The match we're fishing today is only 3 hours long. And sometimes a large amount of bait takes a little bit of time to get going. But I'm prepared to take that gamble on the fact that, you know, it's interesting for you guys to see something a little bit different. So I'm going to feed that. So that was 4 of those, okay? And that is obviously 3 litres. That's gonna make probably about 10 or 11 balls, all right? 10 or 11 balls of ground bait that I can pot in. I'm not gonna be particularly accurate. I'm gonna pot some slightly back up the shelf, left and right, just create a bit of a bed. And in that, I'm gonna put a very small amount of chopped worms and a very small amount of casters, all right? Sort of just feel the palm of my hand here. I'll mix those around and that'll just create sort of this carpet of feed. On the bottom is an odd micro in my feed. I always toss an odd micro in my feed as well, just to give an odd little bit of feed in there. And that'll be all over the bottom there. And hopefully roach and skimmers will come and graze over that. And then I can decide how I want to feed. Do I want to loose feed, pop, top up with balls? I don't know yet. I'm going to find out as the day goes on. On the long line, slightly different. It's all about less is more, if you like. So on the long line, there'll be a very, very small amount of chopped worm. I actually haven't decided yet if I'm going to feed any or not on that long line. And there's just a few dead maggots. Basically, next to no bait at all, because I'm going to put 3 little balls in and I'll probably start on that long line, see if there's an odd bigger fish. I always think the fish sort of start feeding further out early on, and I'm hoping to get on that short line quickly, maybe 20 minutes or so into the match, but we'll see how the long line goes. So that's pretty much the feeding approach that covers my two lines.
Right, well, I've set up now. Lee's still actually doing some ground bait and stuff like that, but I'm going to run you through the most important part of the day is the gear, all the floats, the ground bait and everything like that ready to go. Unfortunately, the weather's turned for the worst. We've got a bit of rain. It's absolutely quite cold as well. Obviously, I've spoke to a couple of people that have actually been to Meadowlands recently, because it's not a venue that I fish. So I've sort of mixed the ground bait up accordingly, what I think. There's a lot of roach feeding at Meadowlands at the moment, so I've taken that into consideration. So I'll go through the ground bait first. I've not mixed up a lot of ground bait. I've probably mixed up about 5 litres in total, which is about 2 kilo, so it's not a lot. But in there, I've got one of my favourite sort of mixes, or my base mixes if you like, which is F1 Dark, Green Thatcher's, but I've also added in 1/2 a bag of Black Roach. Now, I've done that because black roach has got a lot of hemp in it. And obviously, in a silverfish match like I am, if you want to call it a match with Lee, I want to try and make some activity in me peg really quickly, because I'm going to try and catch early. You know, there's no point sitting here for maybe an hour to 2 hours. If I get a bit of activity off the ground bait, hopefully I'll pull in some fish in me peg. Even if it's little roach and perch, you know, to get yourself going, that's what I sort of think about when I'm fishing, you know, a venue like Meadowlands. So I'll run through the bait. So I've got my ground bait there. I've chopped some worms up. Again, I've spoke to a couple of people. They've been catching really big roach in here. I'm not sure where, but I know they've been catching roach up to a pound. And they haven't been catching that many roach in some areas to catch a real good weight. A real good weight. So I've mixed up some worms there, or chopped some worms up. I've got some nice casters, some fresh casters, only about a pint and a half. And I've also got some fluoro pinkies. This is what I'm going to base around me long line, because I'm going to start short, put a little bit more gear out long, and hopefully I can go out there, you know, pinkies. We all know fluoro pinkies, when it's hard, which it could be today, the water's clear, it's cold, you know, it's not great weather. Pinkies just might get you a few fish before you can put bits of worm on, caster, double maggot and bait like that. And then the only other bait I've got is some live maggots. All my bait really is live. I've not really bought any dead baits. When I'm talking about catching roach and things like that with an odd skimmer, I do like live baits. My base mix really for that is my worms. And then I've just got some worms in there, obviously the ones I got left over. Hopefully I can catch on worms on the hook. You know, I've chopped quite a few up anyway, so I've got enough there to probably last me the session. But I've got some live worms in there, which obviously I can chop later, or hopefully put them on the hook if the fishing's that good. Rig-wise, oh, the only other thing I have got actually, which I've just forgot about, I've got a tin of F1 corn. Again, spoke to a few people, they said, look, corn can work quite well. If you catch, you know, you can catch some real big roach and skimmers on it. So I brought a bit of corn, and I will introduce a little bit of that with me ground bait at the start and then see how I go. Rig-wise, really, really simple. I'm fishing, it's always gambles. I've looked at the forecast and the wind, it ain't too bad. So I'm gambling to fish 40 and a half meters with my long line. I'm gonna put it in about that much short. So I've got an option of going to the full length and fishing that far past me ground bait if I need to long. Why am I fishing there? When I plumbed up, it's actually still going at 13, sort of 13 with a dolly, but it's still going. And at 14, it starts to flatten out. Whether that's going to be right or wrong, who knows? That's what's gone through my mind when I plumbed up. I nearly fished 13. I plumbed up. I just didn't quite, I don't know, it didn't click in my mind. It was still on that slope. So I've aimed up for 14 and a half meters. So one rig I've set up for 14 and a half meters is a gram and a half, one of the new power floats. Nice hollow bristle. So we've got that new nickel titanium stem. So it's a gram and a half, nice hollow bristle, because obviously the conditions are quite, you know, quite rough, and it's a deep venue. This is on a top kit plus one. I've actually got a little bit of slack line there, and a simple Olivet setup with just locked in place with a few number eights, and I've got number eights as droppers. So it's nice and positive. I've not opted to set actually anything else up out long, because it is probably a good 12 to 13 foot deep. So that's the rig for fishing out long. And I've actually set up two rigs to fish the short line, which I today is gonna, for me, is gonna be 10 meters. That's what I've decided. It's a nice depth. It's about 8 foot, which I think is a real good depth for roach. All the elastics are all exactly the same. It's 6 original slip. I've just put this, the lube on it, which makes it work really, really well. The first rig I've set up for 10 meters is a power float again, a 0.75. And then going down to the shotting pattern, I've actually got a little bulk of number eights, and then I've got two number tens and two number nines spaced out. So the bulk is probably 2 foot plus away from the hook, and I've got four droppers. And that's the rig I set up because I think if they come off the bottom, if I'm loose feeding there, which I'm hopefully going to, whether it's going to be maggots and casters, probably casters to be honest, trying to catch good quality roach. And then I can put the rig in. I've got that little bulk to everything to catch up because it's quite deep. And then I've got the four droppers to hopefully catch a few on the drop. So that's the first rig for 10 meters. The second rig is exactly the same float, apart from it's a gram. So it's a gram power, blacked out, because everything, you can see your float blacked out much, much better. Like I said, semi-elastic. And all I've got on the gram rig is an Olivet locked in place with a couple of shot, and then three number eight droppers. So it's basically just more positive. If the fishing's really good short, I'll be fishing with this rig. If it's a bit sort of loose feeding, you know, trying to cat off the bottom, then I can use the 0.75, which is obviously a little bit more spaced out shotting. And so that's it really, I'm keeping it nice and simple. I've not set nothing up really short. I'm just trying to keep it nice and simple. I looked at the water, it's clear. Obviously, if it was a bit warmer, we might even be able to catch some big roach down the edge. I honestly don't think that's gonna happen. I think they're gonna be, and I think 10 meters for me, when I plumbed up and it's 8 foot deep, it just felt absolutely dead right. So that's the bait, that's the rigs. We've got a little bit more time to go. I'm gonna put my hands in my pockets because they're absolutely freezing, and we'll catch up with you very shortly. Well, mate, I see you chopping some of your dead worms up.
Yeah, I've picked the live ones out, Dave.
Lee's got some fantastic bait. Most of his worms are dead.
Unfortunately, I picked up one bag that I've had for about 2 months.
I know
months.
You're Northern and you're
yeah,
tight.
Yeah, I'm tight, but, Dave. Yeah, I'm tight. Listen,
worms.
I found my live ones now, so we're all right. What are we saying about this then? Are we ready for a weather battle?
It is a weather battle.
Who can hold on the longest?
Well, I don't know whether I'm going to put any bait on. My hand's been that cold, so you might have an advantage. So N-peg, I can't put bait on.
Yeah.
I'm fishing 14 and a half metres, so...
Oh, yeah. I've gone 13. I've gone 13 on my long line, and I've gone probably like halfway along my number six on the short line, something like that.
10 metres I'm fishing short.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. It doesn't plumb up.
Yours is a bit deep. Is that... Oh, no, yours...
That's my short line.
Yeah, your short line.
About 9.5 foot is.
Yeah, I'm fishing 8. Yeah.
The thing is, I'll tell you
I'm
what.
I'm fishing a bit. Actually, it might be slightly shallower than your peg. Mm. 10 metres.
Mine is really steep. Like, it drops off really fast. And then there's like an area. If you imagine like this bank here, yeah. I reckon I'm plumbing up here and there's a bit of an area that sort of changes only two
or
3 inches.
Yeah, well, that's why I fish 14 now. Because I go to 13 with the dolly butt and it's still going.
Oh, is it? But I see what you're saying. The trouble is, if you're fishing on a slope, it's not that the fish don't feed there. It's just that they're hard to catch, aren't they?
And if it's towing...
Oh, no, it's a nightmare.
That's the trouble with it. That's what we're thinking, or what I'm thinking about today, is this towing. It is trying to back up against the wind.
Is it?
That's
good. That's good news.
That's what I'm hoping is going to happen, because the presentation is so much easier, isn't it?
Oh, mate, so much easier.
If the wind and the tow goes the same way, we've always said about it on all the videos we do.
Yeah, it's horrible.
It makes it really... And I had exactly the same on Saturday in a match, trying to catch F1s.
Yeah.
And it was literally... a nightmare.
Yeah.
And then you speak to people.
Because I don't actually think it's going with the wind. It's the wind. When it goes with the wind, it's the wind that pushes it through. But it's like, so the fish don't like it, do they?
So, but you've set up five
rigs. Yeah, I've got two long. I went for two short, and then I weren't sure, so I doubled up on one.
Fair play. Well, I've only set up three.
Have you? Well, you can borrow one of mine if you want, mate.
No, it's all right. I like the looks of mine. What have you set up? Five, the last five number fives?
I've got sixes and black eight.
See, I told you it was on a flyer. But I've not even got my slip 8 out.
Have you not? I've got a slip 8 for sure.
And I've been here
on
before.
On long, I've only got slip 8.
And how long's your land in that handle?
4 metres. Oh, yeah. Is that all right?
Yeah. Because that's summer as well. Because obviously when you're fishing in deep water, to net a fish in deep water, sometimes you've got to fish a longer land.
Yeah,
you have.
You fish. I mean, everybody's different. I suppose how to set your elastic. My thing, in deep water, I like to set the hook, and I always find slightly heavier elastic helps me with that. Listen, it might be a bit aggressive, but I've never been here, so that's what
I'm
going for.
I fished this lake once or twice just doing films, actually.
Yeah.
And it's been really good. And I've only ever been here when it's actually freezing cold, so...
What's your target weight?
Target weight?
Go on, you set the target
weight. I
don't
know, really. It depends how, you know... I take... £40 now.
Yeah. You can have it, mate.
I don't know.
For both of us.
I honestly don't know.
If we caught £15, I'd be happy in 3 hours.
And I've already said at the start of my little bit that it would depend on how long it takes to get a bite.
Yes, you're right, yeah.
In this time of year.
Sometimes it can be an hour, two hours.
That's what I mean.
You
might not get a bite for an hour. So that will make a massive difference.
Yeah.
On what we end up with.
What we're going to do, tell jokes to fill time if that happens.
Oh, there'd be plenty of jokes. especially in this weather.
Should we put some bait in?
Let's get some bait in.
Let's get some bait in.
Yeah, I'm ready.
Yeah, I'm ready.
I've been ready for 45 minutes. I don't know what you've been doing, but
I'm ready, mate.
You know what I mean? Well, you've got some pellets in there, haven't you?
Yeah, an old pellet, yeah.
It's dodgy, that, innit? Especially being a natural venue, this. Right, best of luck.
Well, welcome to the bit where we give away some free fishing tackle. I've got a lovely little comp here for you today. Now, our intensity feeder reels are some of the best reels on the market if you're an avid feeder angler. Now, they're a big reel, 620 and 720 size, perfect for long distance feeder fishing and heavy duty feeder work. Now, we've got one of each to give away today. So one winner will walk away with a 620, one winner will walk away with a 720 reel. And all you've got to do to stand a chance of winning is put in the comments below a tip that will help a beginner catch more fish. It can be absolutely anything, but if you think a beginner will benefit from your advice, put it in the comments below and I will pick two completely at random. Each of you will walk away with an intensity feeder reel.
Right, we've just got about 10 minutes to go now. So obviously now I want to get my bait prepared for my ground bait that I'm actually going to pot in. Now that's decisions. For me personally today, I want to start at 10 metres. I'm going to start short and go out long if I need to. Hopefully the short line's solid all day, which I don't think it's going to be. But my plan of action is to put some worms in short with not so much ground bait. And I think Lee might be doing something slightly different. And that's not because we've actually spoke about this before, to make the film more interesting. That's what we honestly think. So this film is about our honest approach. So what I'm going to do short, I'm going to put some worms in. So I'm going to get a big handful of worms, a few casters like that, and I'm going to mix enough ground bait in there just to make it like a porridge. A little bit more ground bait. So there's quite a lot of particles in it, but not so much ground bait. Now, whether that's right or wrong, we'll find out. Because I think Lee, like I said, I did hear Lee actually doing his little bit of filming, and I think he's probably going to go towards putting quite a lot of ground bait in short to try and get the roach to settle in. I'm just taking in all the different decisions in my mind, conditions. I know there's a match here over the weekend, so there's been a bit of bait gone in. That is the truth. You know, that's what's going through my mind, and we'll find out whether I'm going to be right or wrong. So I can make a nice ball like that. Yeah, there's enough ground bait, basically, just to hold it together to get it down. Because, as I said, it is 8 or 9 foot deep short, but it's got a lot of worm in it. Well, not a lot of worm, but it's got quite a bit of worm and some casters. And I'll probably end up loose feeding casters over that as we go. So that's me mix for short. I can actually just put a little bit more worm in that. If you want to adjust it to make it a bit wetter, just add a bit more worm, because all the juices leak out into the ground bait and you can get it a little bit wetter. So that's what I'm probably going to pot in at the start. It won't be that big because I want to start short. It's probably going to be, I would say at the start, it's probably going to be that big. About the size of a golf ball. That's what I'm going to put in short. A little bit of loose ground bait, because that makes a bit of a cloud. If there's a few roach about, hopefully they'll come to the cloud and then they'll go down to the bottom for me other bait. Now, me long line, I'm actually going to put a little bit more bait in there. One, I'm fishing long. Two, I'm not going out there straight away. So I want to put a better bait in. Now that's all decisions. There's a guy fishing to my left up there. He's actually fishing a feeder and he's not caught yet. So they're the little things that I'm thinking about. And I'm thinking I've got to go careful today. What's going to happen? You know, he is fishing a feeder for skimmers and he's not caught a skimmer. So I'm not going to overcook it, you know. Like I said, water's clear. You know, I know it's been fished a little bit recently, you know, the days before we come to do this film. And I'm just going to be a little bit sort of cagey how much bait I'm going to put in. So I'm aiming to put sort of 4 balls in. On a big lake like this, it's not a lot of bait. Normally, if I thought it ain't been fished for a week, I'd probably put like 6 or 8 balls in, because it is that sort of venue. So I'm going to get 4 balls of ground bait like that, put that into a separate EVA bowl, and then I'm going to add a bit of guano mix, really. So a little bit of worm, a few casters, not as much, you know, just a little bit. I mean, I'm going to use the ground bait out there to pull the fish in me peg and don't give them so many particles. And what I'm gonna do out there as well is put some pinkies in. I love that, because of the conditions. If it was summertime, you know, October, August, you probably wouldn't even bring any pinkies here. But this time of year, when you think the skimmers are really, you know, they can be a bit cagey, you might have to put double pinky on the hook or a maggot and pinky on the hook. Just have a look at that a minute, see what that looks like when I make a ball up. So if you can see that, that's completely different to like the mix that I've got short, but I'm gonna be potting in four balls like that. So he's got some pinkies, a little bit of worm mixed in. I will put a little bit more worm in there, just so I can see a little bit more in the ball. Give that a good mix around. And I'm not gonna make these up until basically I'm ready to actually ship them out and pot them in, because I've got them like pinkies in there. Just gonna put a few more pinkies in. Like that. And I think that, on a day like today, with all the, you know, with all the things taken into consideration, like I said, it's been fished, the weather, you know, I want to catch pretty quick. Let's have a look at that now. I mean, that looks really nice now. So I've got odd fleck of worm in there, quite a few pinkies, few casters. Obviously, that's the decision I'm going to make. So I'm not going to make them up just yet. Lee's not quite ready, I don't think. So that's what I'm going to be potting in. And obviously, when I do actually start potting in, we'll talk through that as we go. But that's my decision. I think I've sort of explained why I'm doing what I'm doing. And hopefully it works. Fingers crossed, we catch quite quickly and plenty of fish.
Okay, we've got some rigs to talk about. First of all, the long line. Now, the target on the long line is skimmers. Want to get my bait down pretty quick, and it's deep, you know, it's 11, 12 foot deep. It's a deep, deep lake out there. So my favorite pattern, surprise, surprise, is the Kerry float. This is a beautiful float. It's got a nickel titanium stem, which gives me weight in the bottom, but can bend around so it doesn't get out of place. And a nice bright fiber bristle. Love a fiber bristle. It's more sensitive than a hollow bristle. And although I can see hollow bristles really well, I just feel that in the winter, fish are a little bit more cagey, so I love a fibre bristle. And it's got a round body, which is important because I can hold it still. I'm going to be out there fishing for skimmers, and I want to hold the rig still. And that is a 2 gram float, okay? So this is my heavier rig. You can see here I've got an Olivet. That's a 1.25 gram Olivet. Little string of shot underneath it, which helps me the rig kick out. And then I've got a single shot here, and then a double shot on the bottom. May seem a little bit strange, this, but it's a rig actually taught to me years ago by our good cameraman behind the camera today, Joe. And effectively what that does is, this is heavier at this end and it kicks out from the shot and comes down. If I was not to have any shot here, this shot definitely helps bring the rig down straight. So I get all the bonus of having almost like a double bulk, but with that little kicker in between. Just make sure that shot is closer to this bulk than it is your big bulk though. That's an important thing. And then all my rigs have got 16 SFLs on. The deep rigs have got 012, because in deep water, I don't want the line twisting up. So I found a little bit thicker line helps me in that deep water. And on the shallower rigs, I've got 010. And the elastic is a single black 8. Now, a single black 8, for me, when I'm fishing in really deep water, I love to set the hook. So it's a little bit of a compromise, because it's not always the easiest thing to net fish in deep water. You've got to sort of swing them around and pull them up. But I love setting the hook. And that black 8 allows me to definitely do that and power through the float, which I think is really important. Onto the close line, and here I'm fishing for roach. So I've got one of the elastics is a black 8 and two are single 6s. Let's start with the lighter rigs. So the first one, it's about 9.5 foot deep, and this is about the limit of the depth for this float, and it is a shanty. So I've got a 416 shanty, probably the greatest float ever made, a nice visible cane tip. All right, it'll be shotted right down. I've sort of got it set up about 2 or 3 inches over depth, and then as you get down the rig, I've got number 9s and number 10s. Basically, I'll try and hold this up so you can see it here. They're just strung out all the way down the rig. So it's quite positive, because these aren't particularly spaced out massively,
but it's very light. So the bait falls consistently, fish jab it on the way down, and when you catch a fish, effectively you see those little bites, all right? So that's really important. And this is my, hopefully I'm not picking this rig up, because this is my, we're struggling a bit, I need to put something in the net, all right? That's the rig for that. And then my next two rigs are quite positive, and I'm fishing short, I'm fishing for roach, I'm fishing in deep water. I've gone for something a little bit different. And this is from a lot of roach fishing experience that I've had in the past. And I've gone for Paolo floats, which are in effect a pencil style float. And I'm not a massive fan of pencil floats under a gram. But once you get over a gram, I believe they give you a real benefit, because the weight of the float means they're still stable. You don't have to worry about them rocking about because they're a pencil. But it means that there's less resistance on the strike because they're so slim, and there's less resistance for the fish to pull it under. So you can get away with a little bit of a heavier float. So this is a gram, and I've got this shotted with a bulk of shot and then three number nines, I believe these are, down the rig. So again, get the rig down, very steady fall in the last bit. This is the rig I probably will spend most of my time with. It's got a single six elastic, and then a nice strung out shot mean the rig will just fall through dead nice. And then, and that would probably be the best I would do, but because I'm fishing against Des and he's like the best, I need something that's gonna give me a potential winning edge. And I've got a gram and a half Paolo as well, all right? Now I absolutely love, and I mean love, getting bagging on big pencil floats. When you bag on a pencil, it's brilliant. The float sits quickly, it sits fast. You don't feel like you're fishing with a big rig. So a gram and a half feels like you're fishing with like a gram. And I've got a bulk of shot here, and then two number eight droppers. This bulk is a lot closer on this rig. It'll go bosh down to the bottom, drop that bait down, wallop, catch them. If we're catching on this, Des is in trouble. But it's a rig that you might get 20 minutes on throughout the day. If you get an hour on it, it's good night everybody else. But the likelihood is it probably won't come into play. But I always like to give myself that winning option. And that's what this rig does. So there my rigs. I'm ready to go. I think Des is ready to go. Let's get some bait in.
Just I started short and never had a bite, and I've just gone out long. Been there about 5 minutes. I'll just put a maggot on a pinky on. My favourite. Oh, it's actually come off. What an absolute gutter. That could be costly. What a gutter. I think it was a small skimmer actually. It was a big lift bite as well. Well, there you go. At least I've had a bite, which is what I said at the beginning, really. It is about getting your first bite in these conditions. When it's cold, clear, that hopefully is a good sign of things to come. But gutted, really. So just sort of plumbed up. So I've got probably 3 inches of the body out of the water, because it is a big deep lake, or this part of the lake is anyway. And with the conditions, you probably won't be able to see it on the camera, but it's actually towing with the wind, or it's actually pushing through with the wind, and it's actually coming in towards me a bit, which isn't the greatest of presentations on a float. And I think we all know when you get them conditions like that, it always makes fishing a lot harder. If you were actually on a different part of the lake today, it might be actually backing up to away from the, or into the wind, and they would be the real good places to catch. And for me personally, on big lakes like this, when you have got them conditions, you have got to fish more line on the bottom, especially when the fish are on the bottom. Obviously you can catch them on the drop, like maybe on that short line when they start feeding. There's a bite again. So that's awesome. Not sure what that is. I've got to be a bit quiet because Lee will be listening. But so that's on them four balls out there. Plenty, you know, quite a lot of pinkies in me mix. You know. Hopefully. Feels like a roach actually. Wherever it is. Oh yeah, where's he going? Trying to headbutt the bank. Just stood up for a roach, how sad is that? I've actually took a section. I need to actually leave another section on. That's something I've learned immediately. Nice sort of 8-ounce roach. Disgorge a job on him.
Or off the mark, little skimmer. On my long line, put a double maggot on. Just wanted something visible early on when there's not, maybe not as many fish about. It's quite interesting though, because he had it right down and the float was, could see the float wasn't quite right. It wasn't a really positive bite. It was almost like a little lift. So, you know, it was, I sort of struck a little bit tentatively really, because I wasn't expecting it to be on, but he was, we're off the mark, little skimmer. It's a slowish start, you know, we've sort of like 10 minutes or so in. That one didn't even settle. Just lifted the rig up, dropped it back in. And that one didn't even settle, so. Oh, a perch. A perch, but a stampy fish nonetheless. Double maggot seems to be catching the eye at the moment. That's going to happen with the perch. Bait's all right, so let's get them back out there. Give me some confidence. It's not taken ages to get those first sort of few indications, but you know, we're a good 10 minutes in or so, so you know, it's taken a while.
Well, it's quite nice fishing now. Like I said, 14.5 metres. I don't know whether Lee's catching the same fish as me. Started off with a few roach, but it's all little skimmers at the moment, which is what I wasn't expecting, to be honest. So what's going through my mind at the moment is obviously thinking about maybe topping up. I mean, the first drop in, I've had an indication out there after 20 minutes. I'm probably in hindsight, I wish I put like 6 balls in. There we go. It's good fishing though, considering the conditions. You know, it's mega cold. Another little skimmer, I think. Yeah, loads of little skimmers. Brings back the old days at Porth Reservoir, to be honest, them little skimmers like that. And they will take some bait then. You can actually top up quite often. I'm quite surprised how small they are actually for this lake, because last time I come here, which was probably a couple of years ago, the ones I caught were bigger than that. They were like 10 ounces. So perhaps there's been like a proper, you know, perhaps they spawned over the last 3 years and... I remember when I used to, well, when I've been here, like I said, they were bigger than that.
Really?
There's a lift bite again. Lovely. Just like Porth Reservoir used to be. Nice big positive rig, drop it in, little lift bites. Another skimmer. The patch is probably a little bit deep out there for the roach. Definitely need that, them powers on today. Thick, nice, you know, nice positive top. When you're fishing these conditions on big deep, you know, deep lakes like this. The good old F1 maggot floats. No good in this bit. Lovely bite then. And that's what these floats are built for, you know, that's what they're designed for. As well as all the other ones we do. That's what this sort of power float's all about. That's a better skimmer. A little bit bigger. Lovely fishing. Bit bigger, probably 9 ounces. Just let everything catch up. Drop it down. A few casters on that short line. To be honest, if them skimmers stay like that, I can't see me sort of doing much else. That is proper nice fishing out there, isn't it? Straight in, straight down. Probably 3 to the pound, I would say these skimmers are. So, you know, it won't take long to do a weight. Another 9 ounces, I would say. Lee at the moment, Lee doesn't seem to be catching as well as me out long. Now, I don't know why, whether he's not put so much bait in or whether he's done the opposite to me short, I don't know. You know, I don't think he had pinkies with him. And like I said at the start, you know, if he was here and the conditions were not as cold, you wouldn't even bring pinkies. But on their day, to hold fish in your peg or get, you know, get fish in your peg and hold them in, they are a mega.
Okay, a bit of joke out here. It's about an hour in now. And they're both catching skimmers really nicely now. Old Des, struggling a bit with cold hands, bless him, but he's catching well. Lee is also catching well. And it seems like the fish are settling down. And we're catching loads of fish. As you can see, we're under the brollies. We're doing what we can. Be a tight finish come the end, I know that much.
Well, we're about 40 minutes in and caught a few skimmers and then went a bit weird long. Basically, I hooked another 4 fish and they were sort of on and off. Now that's classic skimmers not settling, you know, they're not settled on your bait, or just maybe there's a few too many there. I don't really know. I've had it a few times before and I noticed out the corner of my eye Des come off a couple as well. I think Des is catching them a little bit better than me at the moment on long pole. So I just had a little drop in short to see if it'll go under shore, and I've just topped it up with a little bit of bait long. I didn't feed loads of bait there at the start, so I'm quite surprised that, you know, on that long line, I've sort of bumped the fish because there's not a lot of bait there. And it does look, it appears as if they are not short just yet, which is disappointing. I was hoping they might, you know, because started getting a few bites long, you'd think maybe that they would come in short, but as of yet they haven't. So we'll be back out on the long line very, very rapidly in a minute. So what I've learned so far is that the bites are really finicky. Effectively, there's fish there, but because they're little skimmers, they are the smallest little movements on the float. And originally, and usually when I fish for skimmers, I tend to wait for a bite to develop. I'm going to blow some snot off my hook there, so sorry for the sound. But so what I'm doing is just shipping my pole out and popping my rig in,
and just trying to nail it over the top and strike at the indications, because the indications to me at the moment are skimmer bites. And I think probably, or possibly, the ones that I bumped, I was sort of waiting for the bite to develop, and maybe by that point, the bait was out of the mouth.
Well, I'm just sticking with it at 14.5 metres. That wind's got a little bit nasty. It's making it a lot harder, but since I put that little, that sort of tangerine-sized ball in, they've come back. It's not as sort of hectic as what it was, but the only thing I cancelled out on that topping up ball was pinkies. So what makes me think is next time I top up, I'm definitely going to put some more pinkies in. I've just tried to put more casters in, a little bit of chop worm, to try and maybe catch the better stamp fish, but it doesn't seem to have... Well, it's either the bigger stamp fish ain't feeding, or they're not here. But it's like really nice fishing, to be fair. Little skimmers, no roach. It's all skimmers out there anyway. And like I said, most of them are little lift bites. Odd sort of sail away bite, but most of them are little lifters. And what I don't really want to do is strike it I think it's a bite. I want to make sure there is one on. There's a bite then. Maybe a little fish, though, that is. Whatever that is, it's tiny. It's the smallest fish I've caught. Oh dear, oh, little roach. And it's really weird that you can have that. Sorry, Lee. You what? Come off. A nice lift there, then. He's doing a, I'll tell you what, he's doing quite a bit of moaning. I mean, people say I moan a lot, but I'll tell you what, he's well up there today. Another little skimmer. Got a net then, but just a bit too big to swing. Maybe if I had like an 8 elastic on, you could swing them, but I'd guarantee they'll come off. But that is the only trouble, you've got to use a disgorger on a lot of them, but not fussed about that, I'm getting them out. But just watching Lee as well, that short line, it's not sort of brilliant. And that's, like I said in a lot of my videos, when I'm match fishing, I look at all those little things. All right, we might have fed it differently. So I've got to be aware of that as well. Because Lee actually started long. So I think what he's done is put a lot of bait, or quite a bit of bait in short, and quite negative long. That's what I think he's done. And his gamble might be that the short line becomes really, really good later on. But I'm definitely going to introduce some more pinkies back in, because I've not been bitted out really, putting them pinkies in at the start. I've not had little tiny fish problems, probably because it is like this sort of later goat. So I'm going to probably catch another sort of 4 or 5 fish and then put another ball in. All skimmers though. I had that tiny little roach 5 minutes ago, but it is all skimmers. It's a slightly better one. That's the ones you want. That one's actually like on the, that one's going dark. It's nearly a nice size skimmer. Probably 10 ounces, I'd have thought. If I can get out of him, because my hands are so cold. Nice fish. So I'm just going to plod along now. You'd be a fool really to come off of that, to be honest. Unless I wanted to rest it or it went dead. Just going to put another ball in. It's always gambles now, how you play this when you're topping up. Just going to put a little bit more worm, and even though I've not really got a lot of confidence in putting it on the hook, a few more casters, and I'm also going to put a few pinkies in as well. Just to make sure. I don't think it's going to make a lot of difference putting them pinkies in. It's not as if I'm going to get bitten out. It's definitely not going to be one of them days. A couple of squeezes just to help get it down. and I'm going to go short. Just have a quick look a minute while I'm waiting. Just give that 10 minutes. See, Lee's got a better, another quality fish on short.
I've been having a bit of a problem today, and this doesn't happen to me very often. Been bumping a few fish, and I'm not sure what it is. I tried my elastic. I thought my elastic might be a little bit heavy, but it's definitely not that, because the light elastic's probably lost more. So I'm not sure what it is. And so I put a little bit of bait in out long and just come in on the short line. Just had two or three quick fish, but the skimmers, strangely, which is sort of confusing me a little bit, because, you know, everybody told us that it would be roach that we'd be catching short, not skimmers. And there seems to be a complete lack of roach. I don't think me or Des have had a roach yet. So it's all a bit strange. But there's skimmers on our short line. Well, the skimmers on my short line. And I just had my best one of the day, probably like a pound. So bearing in mind a lot of my longer skimmers are a lot smaller, then that's obviously really good. This one feels like a better one as well. So, you know, sometimes, you know, to pull it back on Des, I needed some slightly better fish. Well, like I say, that first one was a better one. This one's a better one. So like a couple of them is going to really help me. Don't forget, I fed a lot of bait there at the start. So maybe after like a couple of hours, the fish have found that bait on that line, and we just had a, you know, a couple of better ones, which is going to help me out massively, because like I said, I was a bit behind. I don't know the size of Des's fish, but my fish on the long line were small. So I've just put like a... I felt there was some fish there because I was getting liners and indications on that short line. So I've just put like a couple of pinkies on, quite a bright bait that I feel like might pick out a, you know, an odd better fish. I mean, if that stamper skimmer I just had continues, we'll be having an exciting sort of final hour. I mean, like I said before, it's only 3 hours long, the match, so you haven't really got a lot of time to sort of fall behind or anything like that. But a couple of bonus fish on this line cheered me up a little bit from a sort of, like I said, a frustrating little period on the long line. It's funny really, because I'm on the gram and a half rig because it needs sort of holding still. See that sitting up a little bit there. It needs holding still. But I haven't had any roach. I mean, this is the skimmers that I've been catching on the longer line. Didn't quite get him. And they're sort of very small. They're very small skimmers. And they're pesky like that. I started off feeding quite heavily with casters again. You know, local advice was there's a lot of fish on this line, there's a lot of small fish like roach and that. So I sort of thought, well, if I feed heavy with casters, that's the crack, that's what the advice was. But it's not been right today. Like I say, I've sort of eased it off now. I'm only sort of loose feeding a dozen or so at a time because I just don't feel like the roach are feeding, you know. And if you haven't caught a roach, I haven't seen Des catch a roach. So I'm prepared to maybe be a little bit more patient for skimmers and just feed a few less casters to try and catch them a bit quicker, because I think when there's a lot of bait on the bottom, they're harder to catch. But that's where we are at the moment. Hopefully I can keep this short line going.
Okay, so 1 hour to go. Lads are both catching really well in trying conditions. Lee's just gone short and had two decent skimmers. Des has followed suit, come short. Just seen him catch a quality perch and a smaller fish. Gonna go right down to the wire, I reckon. So though Lee was probably a few behind in fish numbers, those two better fish have certainly clawed some ground back, and if they're in the area, a few of them will be very handy. So it's going to go right down to the wire, I reckon. There's just missed a bite there.
The problem I got is Lee's caught, he's catching short and he's catching the same fish as I'm catching long, which are those little skimmers. He's had a few better skimmers as well, but there's no roach, or there's not any roach. I can't catch roach anyway. And I think what's happened is, it is like a skimmer, it's a skimmer match really, but I can't catch them short. I've gone in, literally caught one roach where I thought the short fishing was going to be a lot of roach. But that hasn't happened. So really, I've just sort of got getting my head down, fishing 14.5 metres, catching these little skimmers. It's lovely fishing. Topping up, single maggot. I've put a caster on. I've actually lost one. I'm not sure, it might have been a perch out there on caster. But for sort of speedness, single red maggot is the best. I've tried double maggot. Hasn't made any difference to the stamp of fish. If anything, it just made it longer to get a bite. But Lee's catching really well short the last sort of 20 minutes or so. And there's no stamp fish. It's not as if like they're getting bigger out where I'm fishing. They just seem to be the same size fish. It is, like I said, it is nice fishing. Definitely topping up. You've got to top up pretty regularly. It's like, now I've had a little run of fish there and it needs like a topped up. I need to top up again. Obviously, I put the last boy I put in, I put more pinkies in, and I think it's kept the fish in my peg a bit longer. I think that might be a lifter. So I'm going to get this one out, put another little ball again. What's really surprising is the stamp. I really thought there'd be better stamp ones by now out long. Might get some, you know, sort of pounders, pound and a half fish. Lovely little skimmers, eh? My hands have actually got a bit warmer now as well. I can actually move my hands. Earlier it was really cold. So what I'm going to do, just going to cup in another little ball again. Just put that rig down there a minute. Get my potting kit. I think what's caught me off really is the roach, the lack of roach. And everybody, a couple of people I spoke to, said, yeah, lots of the weights were on the weekend were roach fishing. You know, a lot of the tack of fishing will be around roach. So I'm going to get some casters in there. You know, and I'm not putting little balls in. I don't want to put a little ball in because I want to be able to go out there, concentrate, fish it out, rather than putting tiny little nuggets in. And that's what's so nice fishing a big lake like Meadowlands. You can actually be quite positive. It's going to be very, very difficult unless I get some quality fish out long. It's going to be very, very difficult to sort of stay with him, really. I've definitely caught more. I think I've had a better sort of fishing out long than what he has. I thought I'd just go out there. A fish then, a little fish though, I think. Yeah, a little roach. Where they have been catching quite a lot of big roach, I think. But they don't seem to be playing ball. To be honest, I need to be catching like either better sized roach or skimmers there, and I just don't know whether they're there.
So we are approaching the end of the session. And there's definitely been an arrival short. Des is catching a few, but this has been absolutely fantastic for me the last 20 minutes or so, something like that, maybe a bit longer. Lots of fish in the peg. I've been trying to sort out the feeding. Absolutely no problems at all with anything coming off. Almost every single fish I've had has been landed. So, you know, it's been a really good finish. And I've actually got the, I'm so confident at the moment, I've got the gram and a half Paolo on, which is a big float, but like I said at the start, it's a slim float, so it's sensitive. I've got it shotted down so I can sort of hold it almost like 18 inches above the surface, like that. Let it all straighten out, so I know the bait's straightened out, and then literally just put it into the peg. And then when it goes down and starts fishing, I can get some casters and loose feed. I've been mixing it up a bit with the loose feed. Oh, missed him. You've got to be a bit careful. As soon as I sort of get carried away with the loose feed, I start missing an odd bite. I'm trying not to loose feed too far either. It's going to sound a bit weird, but if I start loose feeding past, because there's such a steep shelf, I feel like it's changing the level of the fish, and as a result, there you go, I'm sort of missing an odd bite. But I haven't been missing many bites. Most of it's been pretty good, but when you do miss an odd bite, the most important thing is to sort of almost like calm yourself down a little bit, slow yourself down a little bit. I'll put that back in. Maybe ease off a feed. Don't, you know, maybe your feed's got a little bit carried away. So you just got to almost try and control the peg all the time. Really interesting fishing. I mean, there's a scary, but considering there was no fish there at the start, there is an absolute scary amount of fish there now. You know, scary amount. These sort of like little skimmers, really. They're sort of different sizes and stamps. Sometimes you get a few bigger ones, sometimes you don't. It was interesting that my sort of two best fish came when I went on it originally. And I think that's probably because it's been left alone. And when you leave a line alone, some bigger fish can settle there. You know, I went in and caught a couple of bigger ones straight away. So I would say that was probably what's been happening. There's a lot of fish there now, though, as you can see. So I'm just going to sort of almost hope for a roach. Yeah, my first roach of the day. We've got 15 minutes left, so I'm just going to try and catch as much as I can on this short line, I think, now until the end. It's going to be ridiculously close, I think. I can't see either one of us coming ahead. Des sort of had by far the best of the first 2 hours, and I've arguably had the best of the last sort of like hour. So the two combined, let's see what happens, and let's see what we end up weighing in.
Right, we're at the real business end now of the session. And I would hate to call a winner at the minute because it's very close. Certainly Des had the better of it in the early going. But Lee's gamble to feed more aggressively on the short line seems to be coming good, because he's catching only small skimmers, but he's had two bonus ones, but they're really coming well now. Des is still catching on the long line over there. Certainly enough maybe to stay ahead in numbers, but Lee is certainly doing his best to come good late on. So it's going to be nip and tuck. The fishing's really good. There's plenty of fish to be caught. So it's going to be an interesting finale when the old scales arrive.
Well, we're on this short now. Just definitely had another. I had another skimmer in about 12 ounces. Single caster. Just that little. I've not gone back to that gram rig. I've just got me 0.75. Just dropping the bulk straight down, folding the line over, and then watching it all go down. Loose feeding casters still with a catapult. Look at that, beautiful. Definitely rocked up short now. I think that feels like a good roach, that. And this is honestly, for us, you know, that's what I thought, that it'd be a lot of, well, I thought the roach would be, that feels like a real nice roach, actually. Oh, yes. That's what we want. That's what I thought we'd be catching. And the sun's come out. My hands have got warmer. The fish are getting bigger. It's a lovely roach, that. Look at that, for a Meadowlands roach. And this is obviously what they've been catching. So that was literally dropping it in, not sort of letting it go down on the side at all. Just trying to get a nice big chunky caster. Always like them nice light brown ones. They're really soft, my casters, today, actually. So I'm just like literally dropping the bulk where my ground bait went in, folding that over. You have to excuse me, my nose keeps running. And letting it all go down, not doing a lot with it, really. It doesn't seem to be one of them days where, look at that. That was straight down. A massive difference in presentation, that. And I've actually given it quite a lot of caster. Another nice skimmer. Tangled around his dorsal. Lovely fish, you know, that now, absolutely lovely. It's nice out long, but when you can get them short, it's how much quicker and easier it is. I mean, that 10 meter, I love 10 meters. I think it's a fantastic length to catch fish on. It just seems so right. You can do, I don't know, it just feels right. How you lie your rig in, the distance from the bank, you know, really efficient. Let's give that quite a lot of caster. I'm not loose feeding every cast either. Sort of like every four or five fish, I give it like, probably like 60 casters now. Just lift and drop as well. Oh yeah, look at that, straight away. That's a decent fish again. So literally just lift and drop that. Another nice skimmer, I think. Oh, hello. That'll do. That'll get old Kerry's bum cheeks talking a bit. Not as big as what I thought it was, actually. Nice fish, though. Look at that, another nice skimmer on that 10 metre line.
Well, we're coming to the end. You get little spells of good and bad times. Sort of had a, like an iffy 10 minutes or so, and then just sort of caught two in two chucks. Sun's come out for the weigh-in after absolutely horrendous weather for most of the day. So that's nice. I've really enjoyed the fishing. I mean, you know, 3 hours has scratched the surface, if you like, of the potential here. I mean, obviously they have matches here all the time, so people who come here will know, but I mean, what a brilliant place to come fishing. It's going to be mega close between me and Des. I wouldn't want to call it. I can't really see Des, but I'm, you know, I think that's the general feeling, that it's going to be really close. So maybe if I could get another couple of fish, it might make all the difference. I've enjoyed it, and I'm enjoying it now that I'm a bit warmer. But it's been great, and I mean, for me, in poor weather, this is the sort of fishing that I want. I want bites, you know. I want a fish a chuck type of thing. So, you know, it's been awesome, absolutely and utterly awesome. I've completely and utterly loved it. Well, mate, that was an interesting 3 hours. What you got to say? Come on, tell me about your day.
Interesting, me trying to put a bait on. How cold my hands have been, I must admit. That's cost me some fish today. But it's been good, hasn't it? The fishing's been good.
Good fishing, yeah.
But it's been completely different to what I have found out from a couple of people.
Me too.
It was going to be roach fishing.
Oh, I was told 90% roach.
But I have had a big one.
Have you?
Yeah, I've had a pounder.
No, what roach? You're kidding.
Yeah, don't mess about me.
I've had two bonus skimmers, probably a pound each, and yeah, then everything else are them little skimmers. Do you know what I mean?
You've had a pound roach. One thing for sure. I don't know what you put out long. Mm. I put four balls in.
Did you? I put three balls in long.
No, you did.
Yeah, I put three balls in long. I put a load short.
Yeah.
But I put three balls in long, thinking I wanted a quick start because we're only fishing 3 hours. Yeah. What's fried my head in today, and I don't know what it is, because I've used the same hooks and line and elastic and everything short, not come off one skimmer. No. But I've bumped some long now.
Deep water.
Yeah, well, other people will have had this, Des. You haven't bumped them, and I have, and I'm thinking, I've had it a million times, but sometimes, the way the bottom is, how they're feeding in your peg...
They're little skimmers as well. They're a nightmare.
But they're not coming offshore. What's that about?
It's a film I've done. It reminded me of Porth Reservoir, because last time I come here, them skimmers, them little skimmers, weren't here really.
They're all sort of 8 to 10 ounce fish. They don't tend to catch them in the matches like we have, though, apparently. No, it's weird, isn't it?
I honestly think, because they had a couple of competitions here over the weekend, I reckon the skimmers have had a go.
Yeah, probably right.
And
yeah,
you putting all that ground bait in short, and me going for rope short.
Yeah.
Like a bit of.
What did you feed short then?
I fed a ball like that with loads of chalk worms.
I fed 12 balls like that. So I wonder if that's why I've caught skimmers earlier. Because combine our 2 days, and we've had an unbelievable day. It's going to be close, I would have thought.
I've caught better than you long, even though you've had a bit of a nightmare with hooking them.
Yeah.
But I've put quite a few pinkies out long.
Yeah, I've not fed any pinkies.
Because I thought it was going to be hard. And I said to camera, we haven't done this. We've not done this as, you do that and I
No, we decided not to talk about it like it was a match, didn't we?
Yeah. And just said, well, that's what we think. Obviously, we've spoke to a couple of people that have fished it on the weekend. A lot of the weights along here are all, 80% roach. I think we both thought it was going to be a lot more roach fishing. And there hasn't.
No.
I've caught hardly any roach.
One or two. That's crazy. Well, you've had a pounder. Chuck it back, because it's been a skimmer match.
And when I first went long...
You had a pounder there as well, did you?
No, sorry. When I first come short, I started short, never had a bite, and it was hard, wasn't it, at the start? Yeah. It was obvious. And I went long, I had a bite really quick, and I thought, this is all right. And then when I did come short, I caught perch.
Did you? Yeah. See, I ain't even had a perch there now. So that's really interesting. Listen, it's been really interesting.
Yeah, it's been good fishing.
I've really enjoyed it in terms of
the
fishing.
Tough, haven't they? With the wind, the cold.
We've had the best. The last 30 minutes has been the best bit.
Yeah, I can actually feel my fingers.
So it'll be all right for weighing in, and that's about it. But look, it's been an absolutely brilliant day. I don't know who's won, because like I said, my last hour was good.
I think you've probably done me, because you caught short, and I couldn't even put a bait on for aftermatch.
Anything? Listen, I've heard it all before. Let's go to the scales and see what happens.
See you in a bit.
Right then, guys. The big moment.
Are we ready?
It's not a big moment.
It's
the moment. Have you zeroed then?
No, that's right.
Yeah, that's right. It's on minus that, dude. Yeah, he absolutely smashed it. What a mate.
Nothing there.
Lovely stamp. No small stamp. They are £20. They're on 19.8. I ain't got that.
19.8.
Nowhere near it.
19.8.
If I could have actually felt my fingers, I could have caught that.
19.8 for Lee.
So you can see, quite a few small ones, and then one decent one.
That's a £2. That.
Yeah,
is.
No, one good fish. Yeah.
I ain't caught that.
Let's just get a snapshot before you.
There we have it.
That's a good stamp of skimmers, though, them. That's a better stamp than what I've caught.
Give over!
I'm telling you.
Give over! God, dear!
Oh, I'm only telling you the truth.
You know, Des.
I'm only telling you the truth. The truth.
You know.
No, I'll have £15, I reckon. Why couldn't it have been like that all day?
It's funny to think, Des, bearing in mind it was like 40 minutes really before we caught, you'd catched over £30 in another 2 hours, easy.
But I spoke to Waco now, he said, no, it's all roach. It's all roach. I've been skimmers.
Of course, yeah.
It's been nothing but skimmers.
Right then, so 19.8 for Lee.
And about £12 for me.
Des?
What have I got?
£12.
What are you admitting to Des? I reckon
I haven't got a clue, because, to be honest, I have struggled with my hands today.
Have you mentioned it?
Have you mentioned
it? I'm not going to lie. I haven't got 19 pounds.
No, you got 23, 24.
No, sorry, not going to happen. Nowhere near it.
I said
15.
Ah, it's mega close, mega close. No. Way over 15 there.
Oh, hello. See, my hands are gone again.
I'm looking for your doggy roach. Let's show the camera your big roach.
There's a few
roaches
there,
there
actually.
I've seen him.
Nowhere near it.
Yeah, way first, yeah.
Said I 15. Oh, my what? 18-10.
Yeah,
18-10. 18-10. Oh, we knew it was close, didn't we? Told you it was close.
Well, considering I've spent an hour not being able to put a bait on, I thought that was pretty good.
What's it, big roach? Which big roach?
There's got a few roach in there.
Yeah, you've got a few roach.
Where is the big roach?
Yeah. Well done, mate.
Where is he?
Yeah, good fun.
Where's my big roach? Zol, do you put my big roach back?
Have a shot then.
Hang on, I've got to find my big roach. I'm really upset that I ain't got that big roach in shot.
Has he grown?
There he is. There he is.
Says he's happy now, he's got his roach in shot.
I knew he was there, look.
Well done, mate.
Stamp roach.
Well, mate, well done. Really close. What was a bit, I thought you had a bit
of your hands are cold, Des. They were cold when we shook hands.
They've actually been a lot worse than I've ever known them, to be honest.
Listen, that was a really close match, wasn't it? I knew it was dead close, knew there was nothing in it. But what I always try to take away something is what could we have done different? I said to you off camera, if we'd have combined our matches, we'd have both had 25 pounds. Yeah. I felt in hindsight, when the way I fed long, I wish I'd have fed a little bit more ground bait at the start and fished a bit more line on the deck. Yes, no, it's all hindsight.
When I was obviously doing my bit, you don't know how it's going to fish from the start, so you don't want to overcook it long.
Just take it steady
because
long.
Because if it's hard, if it's rock hard and you've got to wait 3 hours for the fish to rock up, if you'd have fed it a little bit lighter, you might caught after an hour.
Absolutely,
so
yeah.
I really thought it was going to be, I thought it was going to be a roach match short and a skimmer line, skimmers and roach long. And it's just been an out and out skimmer. Although I have had a couple of nice big roach. Obviously, presentation.
Well done, mate. Well, the presentation's helped you out there. Yeah. I mean, it was brilliant. I knew it was, like I said, we knew it was dead close. But it just goes to show to everybody who's watching, there's two ways to skin a cat. You can, you go on that short line. Mm. Sometimes it can throw up, sometimes it doesn't. The way you fished on the long line has been better than me. You know, it's a brilliant place to come fishing as well. I've really enjoyed myself towards the end when it's been nice and that, and it's been great fishing.
I had a feeling you put a lot more. Well, I put hardly anything in short because I thought it was going to be a roach match. Put a little tiny bit of chop worm in with a bit of ground bait, loose feed casters, catch roach. You know, basically catch roach and keep plundering the skimmers long. What size rig did you think was best long?
Gram and a half. I've had a gram 2.5 and a 2 grammer. But
I have fished.
Did you fish some line on the bottom
then? Yeah, that much on.
Yeah, that's where I've gone wrong long, right? On the long line, I was trying to fish a little bit, not enough line on the bottom. And I said, I think the fish that were long, they're not feeding with confidence. So what happens is, I'm trying to fish dead nice, I'm not hooking them properly. Yeah. Whereas you've ligged a little, you told me you've been using I ain't used a disgorge on long fish. They're all nicked in the bottom lips and
it's also
terrible. For me, that's taught me a lot on that long line, you know.
I've fished not so far over depth, but you're whacking it, aren't you? When you're fishing 10 metres, which is a great distance to catch silvers, you're whacking it, you're whacking the hook into the fish.
I fished a little bit more on the deck short, maybe that's... This is what fishing's all about, though. This is what mash fishing's all about. That's why I love it so much.
If I had put more ground bait in short...
Yeah, you've had a brilliant finish.
I've only done that because I knew you put ground bait in. I put a ball in before I went out long. And I thought, well, I'll just come back in, and it was solid.
Absolutely,
But...
We're learning all the time, aren't we?
You'd have put all that ground bait in, it'd have been a roach day, they might not have wanted ground bait, and you'd have been screwed.
Oh, absolutely, 100%, could have been completely different. So I think the message to everybody is, I hope you've enjoyed it at home. I think I've had a good day, it's been a close match. Thanks for not beating me by loads, I knew you were going to take me down.
I'm bringing my bivy eater with me, so I can actually put a maggot on the hook in the first 2 hours, instead of being like that.
Right, let's get to the pub and warm up. Come on.
See you later.